Hello, thank you for joining in to watch our Understanding Imposter Syndrome and Steps to Breaking Its Cycle workshop brought to you by our MESA STEM Academic Success Center. My name is Angelica and I am a counselor in our center. Today we're going to be talking about imposter syndrome, and it's something that's so important that we talk about because many people have feelings of being an imposter, and it oftentimes leads to a dip in your performance and how you feel about yourself, and it can even lead to burnout. So we're going to be talking about what imposter syndrome is, what it looks like, and we'll go over some steps on how to combat it. So imposter syndrome defined. So here is a visual of what imposter syndrome feels like. Oftentimes your brain is filled with what I think others know of you and instead of what you actually know. So nice little visual. So imposter syndrome is often looks like internalizing a belief that one's success is due to lack or something underdeserving despite of being accomplished, excelled, achieved, and succeeded. Sometimes you'll feel that you're not competent or intelligent as others might think or perceive you. And soon enough, you start feeling that others will discover who you truly are. And those are all feelings. They're not the truth. It's your brain leading you to believe that you're not good enough, and that you're not a hard worker, or that you're not accomplished, but that's all things that are happening in your brain. Sometimes you might feel like a poser, fraud, or phony, and all of this because I mean, these are big feelings that you're dealing with, that you're going through on a day-to-day basis. It does manifest in stress, anxiety, fear. You begin to have negative talks. Negative things are going on in your head. And a lot of the things that we're thinking about, if it's something negative, if we're telling ourselves we're not good enough, you begin to believe that. And sometimes you begin to underperform. So it's really important that if you do have these feelings, that we tackle them and that you overcome this so that it doesn't affect your performance and your achievements in the future. On the next slide here, we see some feelings that you might experience when feeling like an imposter. Here are some signs that you may have experienced imposter syndrome. So, not believing that you have earned your success through your own efforts, instead, you attribute it to chance or luck or another outside variable. Feeling inadequate in terms of your intelligence, ability, education, experiences, and achievements. You're unable to internalize accomplishments, and you don't feel proud of yourself, or you don't believe in your own intelligence, abilities, competencies, and skills. You exaggerate your flaws and failings. Feeling that one has to be the best in order to be valued. And of course, it is important to take pride in yourself, right? But nobody's perfect. It's okay to make mistakes. Feeling like you're not enough, qualified, or have reached levels beyond your perceived abilities. Oftentimes, you may avoid new opportunities or challenges for fear that you won't be able to measure up, or fill in someone's shoes. And all this does is, not allow you that experience to grow and to develop. Observing that you have different backgrounds, genders, than other people, and you feel paralyzed by that comparison. And something to know, a lot of the times, it's easy to compare ourselves to others, right? And you're looking at maybe someone that you look up to, and you're like, oh, I want to be there. And that's great to use it as motivation. But try to not compare yourself to others, because remember, you might be comparing yourself to someone's chapter five when you're at your chapter two, right? So try to avoid comparing yourself to others. You do use your mentors as inspiration, as motivation, but do avoid that comparison whenever possible. All right, so in STEM, imposter syndrome is very common, and the reason for this is because there's a lot of change in terms of as a student, you're taking new classes every semester. You're taking a course that's going to prepare you for the next a higher and more advanced course. in the professional world, you're seeing a lot of advancements, and it's so rapid. It's hard for a human to ever keep up, but we oftentimes feel that we should be advancing very quickly. And the reality of it is that our development as humans, you know, it is a process. So results, and so, you know, how does imposter syndrome impact you? You oftentimes are overwhelmed with self-doubt. You begin to believe that you're not capable, believing that your failures won't be accepted. And, you know, keep in mind, failing is part of growing and learning. You begin to lose faith in your abilities. You begin to compare yourself to others, and you self-sabotage. You lose sight that competency comes from learning from others rather than from competing, right? We can learn from others. We can grow from others. You begin not to ask for help or sharing workload and working as a team. You begin to isolate and work on your own because you begin to worry that you're not able to collaborate and work together with your peers. Internal struggles that cause a feeling of being trapped or stuck. And oftentimes you might either procrastinate and wait until the last minute to handle tasks, or you might find yourself over preparing because you don't feel that you have the skills and abilities, and you over prepare to the point of where you're stressed out and become anxious. And, you know, stress is good to a certain level, but when you when you get into a place where you're creating, you know, an overwhelming stress on yourself because you're worried, because you're anxious about something that you're working on, that's where we want to, you know, take a step back and maintain a good balance. So 70% of adults do experience feeling like an imposter at least once in their lifetime. Imposter syndrome makes you feel like you aren't good enough at what you're doing, but oftentimes these are just only feelings and they're based on fear and not reality. So the imposter syndrome cycle and what it looks like. So here's an illustration of what the cycle looks like. So you're tasked with a new project. You have anxiety, you're worried about it. You want to do, you know, your best work possible. You're starting to feel that you can't do your best work possible, or that you're not enough, or that you're not fit for this project. You might procrastinate and not get started on it until the last minute, or you might just over prepare and spend days and hours, endless time preparing for this project. Then you go on and complete the project. You have a sense of relief. You feel accomplished. And then as you're processing your accomplishments, then you might start feeling like, I was just lucky. Somebody else could have done a better job. I should have done a better job. I could have done this differently. Then again, you begin to have an increased sense of self-doubt, anxiety. You begin to feel like a fraud. And then you move forward from that. Then you're onto the new project, and the cycle keeps repeating itself. So it's important that you believe in yourself, that you, if you're in a position, if you're working on a project, if you're going through a class, that you're aware of your strengths and your abilities, and that you know that you belong there. And that brings me onto the next point. You belong. Failure is a key component of learning, especially in STEM. Some students have never experienced failure, low grades before coming to college. And it might be the first time as a college student where you earn a low grade on an exam, on an assignment. You might even find yourself failing a class. And if you have felt like an imposter as a college student in STEM, keep in mind you are in a major that's demanding. So there might be those situations where you do feel, and you want to use those opportunities as growing experiences and learning experiences to reflect on that particular experience and look at it. How can I grow from this? How can I do better? What can I do to improve? Additionally, more of your peers are experiencing failure than you think. You're not alone. Imposter syndrome is a mindset cycle. Literally, we psych ourselves out to believe that we are perfectly capable of learning and performing. The cycle gets reinforced and proves itself because of the mindset. So it's all about perspective. Right? Very prominent in women in engineering, computer science, and other students who don't see others similar to themselves in the in their peers, co-workers, or instructors. We are in control of our thoughts and beliefs. Your brain is a very powerful piece of you. So make sure that you know you're going in with a positive mindset and that you're kind to yourself and that you view yourself in a positive light. STEM is challenging. The coursework is hard. Your instructors can be rigorous at times. Some of your peers might not be very similar to you. Our campus is very diverse. There is bigger bridges to cross, but you do belong here, and you're capable of your success, and you're not a poser. Do not let anything convince you otherwise, especially yourself. So let's go over breaking the cycles. We have six steps. Step one, focus on the facts. Recognize that feelings are associated with imposter syndrome as rooted in fear, but not the fact. Focus on your strengths and recognize that failure is a fact of learning. Don't compare yourself to others and find fault with yourself, feeling not good enough or not belonging. Like I mentioned, be kind to yourself, have a positive outlook on who you are. Focus on what others are saying, doing, and learning from them, not what you don't know, and compare yourself to them. You know, use others that you perceive to know more than you to learn from them, to grow from them, to make part of like that support network. Step two, acknowledge, validate, and let go. Don't dismiss or ignore it. Your feelings are important. Acknowledge and honor them. Feeling unqualified doesn't mean you are. It's okay to acknowledge your feelings of inadequacy and validate that it's okay, but let them go and allow yourself to move forward and prove yourself. Minimize social media. What you're seeing on social media sometimes isn't true. A lot of the things may be unrealistic. You might be seeing these big, beautiful pictures that are posted of someone's lifestyle, of somebody's accomplishment. Sometimes they're exaggerated and unrealistic. So, you know, take what you see on social media as what it is, but don't compare yourself with what you're seeing people post on social media. Don't fight the feels of not belonging. Lean into them, accept them, and grow through them. Step three, reframe your thoughts. Recognize how powerful your thoughts are. They shape our reality positively and negatively. Allow yourself to reshape your thoughts and change your reality to have a more positive outlook of who you are and where you're headed. Write out your accomplishments, abilities, skills, success. Post them somewhere where you're able to see them every day and honor them within yourself. I think it's always important to remind ourselves, you know, what we're good at, what our accomplishments are, what our successes are, you know, because it keeps you motivated and it keeps you feeling confident. Take baby steps. Don't focus on perfection. Do things reasonably well and reward your reasonable success. Turn thoughts and of attributing success to luck into feelings of gratitude. You know, be proud of yourself. Be proud of your accomplishments. Acknowledge that you're a hard worker and that you've worked hard to accomplish your success. Step four, share how you feel. Sometimes it's easier said than done. You know, develop your support system. Connect with your instructors, your counselors. You know, we're here to support you. Talk to others. Irrational beliefs fester when they are hidden and not talked about. Seek out a mentor, someone in STEM, and who you can look up to and talk openly. Seek out resources. There's a health center here on campus, your support network, utilize it. All right, so step five, learn from your peers and help others out. Be of support to those around you. No one is a master of everything, but everyone is a master of something. When working with your peers, exchange knowledge while mastering new skills. Honor the value that you add while learning new things from your peers. Work together to expand knowledge, not as a measure of yourself and your abilities. Help others with feelings of not belonging or inferiority. Reach out to others who seem alone and bring them back into the fold of others. Step six, pat yourself on the back. Celebrate your achievements and sink yourself into feeling good about yourself, even if it feels awkward. Practice kudos to yourselves. Try to reflect as much as you can. Maybe like at the end of every week, point out to yourself, the things that went well, your wins, your success, and give yourself that recognition that you deserve. Share these successes with people who will reinforce good feelings surrounding these successes. Trade kudos with one another as well. Use these feelings of pride in yourself as a source of empowerment and confidence to propel you forward. And never let feelings of inferiority or not belonging stop you from pursuing your goals. Keep your inner critic at bay. Refuse to be stopped and maintain a mindset that supports that drive. Right, thank you. That is our last slide. Thank you so much for joining. Like I mentioned, you have access to the PowerPoint right underneath the video. Have a wonderful rest of your day.